Welcome to the Noonday Meditation with Wayne Vernon.
Matthew chapter 28, 18 to 20. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely, I am with you always to the very end of the age. Our Lord's final comment regarding the Great Commission, as stated here in Matthew, holds amazing implications for the followers of Jesus Christ today. You see, Jesus' command to his disciples as they engage in global discipleship closes with a commitment of divine accompaniment. But note carefully, the word idu, translated lo, is used, says one writer, to enliven the narrative. It is either used to awaken attention or to introduce something new in the middle of a speech. It is also used to emphasize the importance of a subject, or it is used as a summons for a more careful consideration and observation. The NIV renders this word surely, other translations assuredly, etc. However, it is translated here in the text, bringing out the force of the text. Our Lord wanted to convey to his disciples the assurance of his divine presence. He does not want them to overlook this aspect of the assignment that they have received. But notice our Lord's emphasis on the extent of his presence with his apostles and with us today. He says that in two assurances, a double layer of assurance. One, he says, I am with you always. And then he says, secondly, to the very end of the age. I am with you always is reminiscent of the Emmanuel theme in Scripture. But interestingly, he uses the double personal reference here, ego emi. The literal reading of ego emi in the Greek is I am with you, or I myself am with you to the very end of the age. The double assurance our Lord provides his disciples is the same for us today. He is personally with us and will continue to be with us and with his church. His presence, his divine presence, was demonstrated in Mark chapter 16 and the verse 20. The disciples went out and preached everywhere, and the Lord worked with them and confirmed his word by signs that accompanied it. It is also demonstrated throughout the book of Acts as God manifested his presence. His manifest presence was evident among the believers of the early church. And so Matthew 28 and the verse 20, and surely I am with you always to the very end of the age, is the greatest assurance that the believers have as we engage in global discipleship. And I pray that today you will sense the sustaining, supporting, secure hand of God in your life. May you not feel alone or on your own, but may you feel safe, supported, and secure as you seek to be faithful to the Great Commission. Should you need further instructions in these matters, please feel free to text the number 647-696-0422. And if you desire to surrender your life to the Lord today, and this is a good day to do so, please text the word salvation to that number as well. Someone is standing by to support you at this time. Please remember to pick up your copy of my book, Six Practices of Effective Leadership, on Amazon. The link is provided in the description below. You could get your hard copy or your Kindle version. And please join us as we travel to the Cayman Islands next week for the National Convention of the Church of God in the Cayman Islands with Bishop Neil Morris and First Lady Beverly Morris. It's going to be an amazing time, and we're going to be promoting the book, we're going to be signing books, we're going to have an amazing time in the Cayman Islands. Looking forward to seeing all of you who are able to be there. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen.
Thank you for listening to the Noonday Meditation with Pastor Wayne Vernon. Please forward this study to your friends, your relatives, associates, neighbors, and all those persons in your social network. If you have a prayer request, please feel free to communicate with us, and we will commit to supporting you in prayer. Until we meet again tomorrow, Shalom.